the biggest percentage of Ugandans rent. This means that it is a business. Previously, we have not been having laws that govern the tenants and the landlords. But last week, our president signed this bill and it is now a law. This means that if you're out there and you work contrary to what the law says, you can actually be imprisoned. But my question is, do you know what this law entails? If you're a landlord, do you know what you're supposed to do? Or if you're a tenant, do you know what is expected of you? Today, I'm so privileged to host one of the stakeholders in this business. And this is the landlord who's going to take us through everything that they've been facing or they know in this business. My name is Hilda Kamkama, and this is The Home Affair.
What excites me about this law is that part where they put that if the tenant doesn't pay their rent within 30 days, that we're allowed to do what the law has allowed us to do, to evict them. We're dealing with these tenants. The tenant can even spend 2 months, 3 months, and they're not paying. And when you call them, all they have to say is that, where do you want me to get the money from? But now the law has made it so straight for us that we are allowed to take action within 30 days, and that helps us as us landlords. Mm. Yes.
We have had issues in the past whereby tenants will come to you, like to your house, and then they ruin it, then go when the house is left in two pieces.
Mm-hmm.
Now it says otherwise. Please.
They were actually damaging it beyond even repair. Yeah. But right now, with this new law, that these people are going to be responsible for what they've been doing to our houses. They're going to be paying the security deposit. In the past, we were trying to make them pay security deposit, but most of the tenants were not accepting to pay the security deposit. They would ask you much questions, a lot of questions about security deposit. But now I'm very, very happy to see that the law has helped us put it in place, that these people have to pay, the tenants actually have to pay for what they've caused, the damage they've caused, sorry.
Initially, you as the landlords would just determine which currency to pay for your property. But now, we have that guideline that it's no more telling us, no, you're going to pay in dollars.
Yes.
Is it affecting you? Of course, to us, we are happy because now we can pay you in UGX because that's our currency that is governing here. Unlike then when you tell us it's dollars. So what is about that?
Okay. For other landlords, apart from CAF properties, I'm actually very sorry for them, that the landlords that were charging in dollars. Those ones, I'm actually very sorry for them, that they might incur that loss or they might have a problem with it. But as ASCAF properties, we're actually very, very happy about it because we're receiving our money in shillings, whether it's in Kenyan shillings, whether dollars, whether Ugandan shillings, for us, as long as the tenant brings the money.
Now, we have also had another challenge whereby landlords would come and just evict you, though they want, though they feel like they want, maybe they've sold the building, now they come and tell you, next week, we don't need anyone.
Yeah.
Now it has been stipulated clearly.
Mostly banks.
You must give us 60 days before eviction to like you give the tenant that space for them to prepare themselves.
Yes.
Don't you think it's a good thing?
It is. Actually, it is. It's a very, very good thing. I am a landlord. I am a property manager. But somehow, I am also a tenant somewhere, somehow. So this makes me happy as a tenant, that the landlords are not just not going to act on their emotions, act on their feelings. Now they're going to act by the law, that evicting someone, you have to first pass through the law, that they have to take, you give them a notice, they prepare themselves, because going to another place, they have to pay 3 months. True. There is security deposit, there is those 2 months of rent. So I think it's a good thing.
We also know that in the past, landlords would determine how many months they want to be paid up front before you take on their property.
Their property.
Others would tell you in 6 months.
Yes.
But now, there are three.
3 months.
But not more than 3 months.
The tenants have to pay 1 month. Or as 3 months. It depends on the talk that you people have had, the mutual agreement. But I wasn't really onto it. I wasn't supporting it, making tenants pay beyond what they're supposed to pay. The person has not yet lived in the house. They have not used the services. Let's take it that they've not used the services yet. And you're making them pay 4 months up front for the services they've not actually used. And some landlords, when it used to come to the time of giving them back the money, they would actually not give it back. The tenant has paid 3 months up front, but they're not giving it back. The tenant has stayed there 1 month, 2 months. They're allowed to say that, I'm not comfortable with this place, I need to move. But other landlords were not accepting that. So with the law, I think it's okay.
What is that favorable time? That one must be given.
The favorable time is, I think, 1 month. Because with CAF properties, we make our tenants pay 1 month up front. Like, let me say, we're in June.
Yes.
So from 1st to 5th of June, they would have completed their month. Because we are actually sure that you're spending this month in this house. So you pay for June, but not at the end.
Okay.
Yes, because these tenants, when they've already used the service, they've spent their CA month. Now we're going to another CA month. They're very comfortable. Mm-hmm. So at least you pay from 1st to 5th of June. Mm-hmm. Yes.
Now, about the 10% increment. I mean, you guys had that liberty to increase at any time.
Mm-hmm.
Also, the amount you feel like increasing.
Mm.
Now, it is not 10%. You're not supposed to increase more than 10%.
Mm-hmm.
How do you feel about that?
Like I'd said before, I'm actually happy about the law. The law has just made everything to be black and white, and it's out there for everyone. With CAF properties, before we were doing this, before we increase rent, we'd give you a notice, and we wouldn't increase more than 10% because we were actually trying to act with the law. The law was there, but it wasn't emphasized. Yes. The 10%, it's okay.
Landlords have been designing their own agreements, like the tenant-landlord agreement, without certain clauses. Okay, it would be them. Now, aren't those... We have found that some of those agreements have really, really been harsh to the tenants. Could you take us briefly on your own agreements that you have been sharing with your tenants?
Yes. It has helped us, because most of the tenants, you would give them a tenant's agreement, they would refuse to actually to sign them.
Oh.
Yes. Most of the tenants would actually refuse to sign these tenants agreements, but now that the law has helped us, they're going to start signing them. We actually have tenants that you keep on calling, please sign my tenants agreement, please sign my tenants agreement, and they never sign them. But now the law is making our work easy.
Yeah, because now it is actually required for every tenant to hang. You see the way we put the certificates of incorporation in every business. What other challenges have you been having with your agreement?
The only challenge we've been having is the tenants accepting to what we've been putting in our tenants agreement. And if you can read through our tenants agreement, you'll see that the new laws, our tenants agreement does not differ far from the new laws.
Who designed for you that? Because if it is not differing, it means you must have had someone good, really, who understands both parties to come up with this.
It was a team of CAF properties a team of co-properties and also our lawyer. So we had our lawyer to guide us through the law, and us, the fact that we've been in business for a long time, we're seeing these challenges, so we're coming up with the laws slowly by slowly that, you know what, these people are damaging the houses, why don't we make them pay us a fee called security deposit? So we'd come up with that, and we would see these laws in other countries, in other places, so we came up with them as a team.
So Leila, for our consumer consumption, how long have you been in this business?
We've been in this business for over 5 years.
Okay.
Yes.
And have you been operating here?
Yes, we've been operating here in Uganda.
Specific region or
We are not limited. We can go up to Gushenyi, we can go anywhere. Like our vision says, we are here to conquer not only Uganda, but East Africa. So right now we are still working small. We are still small. We are still working in Uganda, but we shall go even up to East Africa, Kenya, Tanzania, everywhere. Yes, we don't have a specific region.
Take us through, like, what do you feel? Or where do you see the future of Uganda with this kind of law?
Oh, the future of Uganda is going to be bright.
Yeah, in the business.
It's going to be bright. Because first of all, the first law that came out is for us, the landlords, to be paying taxes. Mm. I guess that helps with the Ugandan revenue. Because the property thing was bringing in a lot of money, so it helps with the revenue. And with us, it actually also helps us, the tenants, to be up straight, for our businesses to move also, like us property managers, that we're not really going to face a hard time with this new law. It is everything for us. The way you want to buy food, you buy anything, you should also consider rent. Pay your rent. Because the way you pay for school fees, the same way you should treat rent. Because this person has put this business in there for them to make money. Don't make them lose money. Because you're already using their services. Kindly just pay the rent and act with the law. This law has actually helped us. It has made things clear. Our tenants have been paying through bank. With car properties, they've been paying through bank. And with the tenants that we've been having a hard time with, can I put your money on mobile money? No. Can we bring the money there? The bank has helped us. Because some tenants would say, I paid the money to someone else. Fraud is going to go away. That if you're paying the money, you're paying it to the landlord's bank account. And I guess it will also help with the revenue, that they'll be keeping track of the money. But we advise our clients, and in one of our services, we do tax advisory.
Okay.
Yes, we don't advise them to that we are advising about the tax, but we advise them to pay the taxes, because we face the challenge that some landlords have not paid, they don't want to pay their taxes. So with car properties, we advise them to pay their taxes.
Now, are there some of the challenges that you as a business face, and you feel they are not captured in the just signed law?
Yes. We are actually facing a challenge with taxes. However much I am happy to talk about taxes, for us to be paying them, but we're also facing a challenge of taxes. We have two types of taxes that are imposed on us.
Which one are those, please?
We have the ground tax and the rental tax. The ground tax, that's the municipality tax. I think it's collected with the municipality. And then this rental, every landlord, as long as you're a landlord, you have to pay a certain...
But the municipality one collects that to clean for you, take away garbage, clear. That's the tax that helps them to give you a better service.
Actually, we pay for this tax, but we don't see the services. I'm sorry to say that we pay for these taxes. Yeah. We have buildings that are next to trenches.
Yes.
But you are not allowed to clean that trench. And they are not doing their work. So we are facing that problem. You don't know what to do. You want that trench to be clean, but you also scared that if KCC finds you cleaning it, they're going to take you. And yet you're helping them and they're not doing their work. Mm. So we're paying for the taxes, but you're not receiving the services.
Mm. You talked about the tax. The recent budget that had just been read yesterday. Mm. Actually, this is what happens. If you're a landlord and you're earning like 2.5 and above on your property, there is this tax. That percentage, it is
2.5%,
which is going to be going back to the taxes.
Mm.
Then on the other hand, for the hotels and the lodges, the VAT, which is 18%, has been erased, like they're not paying that. So what do you think?
I don't think that is actually really fair, because they're putting this tax on us. First, they impose the tax on us, that 2.5. And with landlords, I don't think most of the landlords are actually happy with this tax. And then the hotels that actually make more money than us, they have removed the tax. To me, it doesn't really make sense. These hotels should also be charged, because these hotels make more money than us. Someone with a hotel can, let me say that lodges, these hotels, someone can enter two clients in a day, or one client, let me say just two clients in a day, the same room, they're paying around 50,000 or 100,000, but me, I'm charging 400,000 the whole month, and then I'm the one to pay the tax. The other person is not paying the tax. How fair is that?
So, Leila, have you come up like to express such a dissatisfaction to any of the...
As a landlord?
Yes.
As CAF Properties, I know where to go, because we have an association called ERA.
Mm.
But I don't think most of the landlords down there know about this. They don't know about this organization. Not much people know about it. I might even be speaking about ERA, and you actually don't even know what ERA stands for.
No, since I'm not into that business.
Yes, so I think they should make themselves more available for more landlords. Mm. Yes, the landlords should actually know about them. Mm. This is how we're going to be tabling out what's oppressing us, how the challenges that we are facing.
We have the law, and the budget has just been read. We have taxes that have been increased to the landlords. And then we have some taxes that have been erased from hotels. But putting that aside, the landlord and the tenant agreement, the Tenant Act has now been signed and it is a law. So it means we are going to find justice between the tenants and the landlords. So we are now going to be bringing you more of this when we talk about the tenants. And let's hear what they say. Thank you very much. Don't touch your dial. I'm coming back.